Alright, so, first off, our game ended 55-41. So, for those of you who are looking for a score, there you go. At any rate, summary for Imperial Settlers. Now, geez, in the last week, I think we've played this 6 times. Which, when you're reviewing games, you don't get to repeat stuff much up until the time for reviewing is nearly upon you. And we weren't really planning on reviewing this until 3 hours ago, maybe? Something like that. So, we had been playing this just because, I mean, the setup is amazingly quick. You pull the cards out of the bag, quick shuffle, you're good to go. And you get a surprisingly deep experience for, you know, a card-based civilization builder of sorts, you know, and it on the surface looks kind of light, but really you get sucked into what your little world is doing, you know, your little people's there. It's like, yay, there's 50,000 of us. I have so many fatties. We're going to conquer the little, whatever this thing is. I guess they're building something. Oh, yeah, they're making a house, aren't they? I never really looked that close at the realm. Oh, I'm going to take over the house. You know, it's great fun. You know, the intricacy of the combos you can get going. I mean, as you saw, you know, around, I think it was turn 4, when just that one building of mine produced the resources for the next building, for the next building, for the next building, and then enabled me to sit there and activate point generator, point generator, point generator, point generator, point. I mean, it was just, when things like that fall into place, it feels fantastic. You're like, oh man, look at this, pew, look at it all go, it's great. You know, it's a lot of fun. It's so easy to teach. I mean, you can sit down and explain this game to anyone in 5 minutes. You know, it's so simple, so easy to understand. You know, even non-gamers won't struggle too much with this one, because as long as you've got one person, you know, who understands the phase structure and can say, okay, now we're doing this, now we're doing that, it's easy for novice players and non-gamer types to follow along. Now, the amount of strategy involved may be a bit much for non-gamer types, but, you know, as long as you're just playing to have a good time, they should still enjoy it. It's going to feel fun, even if their final score isn't terribly impressive. And I mean, hey, they're non-gamers. I doubt they hang out on Board Game Geek, so tell them their score is impressive, even if it's not. You know, what are they gonna know? Anyway. So, you know, the components are just delightful. I love these little apples and the fat guy meeples and big old
pieces
coins.
Pieces of wood
and
shaped like wood. Just,
yeah. The wood shaped like wood, which is always so ironic to me. It's like you could have just given us a box full of sticks. Like actual sticks.
The stone.
That
would have
been
kind of
cool, but I suspect there would be like import restrictions or something. You know, probably like wood parasite issues. I don't know. they're just fun. They're cute. They're colorful. They're nice to fiddle with. You know, you can get your little fat guys there to do handstands and stuff. You know, cartwheel. Anyway, you know, we love the graphic design to this, and it's got Ignacy's usual flair. You know, in any game he does, there's always that certain, I want to say, quirkiness to it, where, you know, it seems like, you know, oh, a civ builder, okay. But it just feels different somehow. His games are always unique. Even ones like The Witcher that we don't care for, it certainly has that unique, quirky quality that Ignacy brings to his games. And Imperial Settlers is really his playground. It's the more Eurocentric kind of focus that he does so well. And he does it phenomenally well here. You know, if you like any of his other major games, there's a good chance you'll like this one. And you certainly won't be disappointed, even if you aren't as big a fan of some of his others, because just the accessibility of this game, the fact that you can have a somewhat heavier experience with a setup time of minutes. You know, you bag each individual faction, and then you bag the common cards, you pull out the decks, you shuffle them, you're good. Go ahead, play. It is so amazingly quick and simple. It's wonderful. You know, none of this. Okay, let's see. Now I need to put 3 apples in section 2. And let's see. I'm going to do this to the staff. You know, that just is mind-numbing. I mean, I'm sure some people are like, ooh, setup, good times. But it just, it makes us go, You know, I'm looking at you, Android. I'm looking square at you, buddy. I love you, but...
Oh, setup my goodness. Time stops if you're getting played. Oh, my goodness,
and that 48-page rule book. Oh, yeah, this is not the summary for Android, which we will film someday, but my goodness, that game. And not the point. Not Android. So, you know... Hopefully, you know, you watched the gameplay segment and you got a pretty good idea of what to expect here. You know, we never stage any of it. You know, we just play the game and you get to watch. So that's a legitimate example of the experience. Hopefully that was useful to you in some way. Hopefully my random jabbering here was useful to you in some way. Hopefully I haven't said enough times that you've shut off the video. Geez Louise, even when you're thinking about it, you can't stop. Right. Yeah, hey, right. We'll use that one for one.
Okay.
Anyway, so I think that probably about covers it pretty well. Anything I'm missing?
How much is it?
Oh, right, of course, the budget element. Last I checked, it was floating around $40-$50 online, which is a little steep for the components. I mean, I love these little guys, but it is kind of hard to see $40-$50 in the bits. But in the gameplay, absolutely. Absolutely. It's one that we are going to keep pulling out long after we're finished reviewing it. And, you know, you don't get a lot of opportunities to pull stuff out that isn't a pending video. So that should speak volumes right there. So yeah, definitely consider checking this out at the very least. See if, you know, game store or friend or somebody has it, because it's worth giving a try. You know, some people don't care for it. We got it from a friend who bought it, you know, played it once, was like, bleh. But to us, fantastic. We've enjoyed it immensely. So, you know, consider checking it out. Hopefully you got some use out of this. And that I didn't say too many times.
Or repeat yourself.
Shut up. Shut up. Shut up. All right. Well, always leave them laughing. So get off your computer and play some more games.